this braided crown halo type, not really halo type girl. I don't know what kind of hairstyle this is, but I get a lot of compliments. I'm just gonna show you how to do this. It's really easy. You do have to know how to braid, and you can use your hair, weave, a wig, whatever you know you choose to do. But it's really simple, and it takes about 5 to 7 minutes. It depends on how fast you braid. So yeah, for this tutorial you will need rubber bands. I use 2. You'll need a brush, just my handy dandy brush. You'll need bobby pins. Okay, so starting off, this is what my hair looks like. This is the texture that it has after I've worn it in a braid all day. This texture does not last a long time because it's a loose braid. Hair details, this is the Real Hair Lovers Royal Brazil. This is the Real Hair Lovers Royal Brazilian in the inches, 16-inch closure, if I'm not mistaken, yes, 14, 16, and 18 bundles. And I just had my beautician layer the closure so it would look a little bit better. But I knew that the longest length of the closure of my hair that I wanted was 18. So I just got a longer closure and just, you know, layer that up. So yeah, to start off, this is what the hair looks like. Just, you know, normal, everyday type hair. I got really tired of this, so I decided to do something different. I always start on the left side of my hair. And what I do is I part my hair to about right there. So it's not half, it's more so like just the one side of my hair, like the left smaller side of my hair. And then I just tie off this side. Now that this side of my hair is completely out of the way, I will be focusing on braiding this side of my hair. This is a closure wig for anyone who's wondering. So you can do this style with your real hair, with just a traditional sew-in, or with a closure wig, or frontal wig as well. So I'm gonna start off by just, you know, brushing through my hair, making sure there are no tangles, all that good stuff. And if you see me looking at something, I'm looking at my mirror right here. Okay, so whenever you have all the kinks out, you're gonna start with your traditional braid. And when you do this part, make sure you're braiding fairly tight. And this doesn't have to be perfect, by the way. But you do want it to be tight because you're going to be pulling this braid 100%, just the braided loops, you're going to be pulling them like crazy. So you want to make sure this hairstyle is really, 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 you know, tight when you braid it. That was just a piece of hair that wasn't supposed to be in there. No, you do not have to braid all the way to the end. And yes, it does stay. This hair is very, very silky. And normally it would not stay braided without a rubber band, but because I've braided it and it has a slight texture, it stays. So, yeah. Now I just take the scrunchie off of this side of my hair and I go all the way to the nape area. So like right here. And I'll just leave this hair loose. And what I'm gonna do is take the hair that is right here and connect it with the braid. So just tie this part right on back up. so it's out the way. And then I'll make sure this part right here is detangled. Now I'm going to take my rubber band and I'm going to take the braid, pull it around the back of my hair. And connect that piece of hair that is loose right there. So I'm gonna take it all the way over. And no, this does not have to be perfect. I'm just gonna pull it through about two times. So that is nice and slow. Then you can take it and tighten. Okay, so now I have that, and that braid is nice and snug and secure. Next is this side, just detangling it again. I'm gonna repeat the same steps, just normally braiding it. What you want to do is make sure this braid is extremely neat and tight, because you're going to be pulling it and making it not so neat. And you know, I'd rather start from it being neat and then me making it not so neat versus it being a tangled ball of a mess and then trying to make it look cute and messy. Like, no. Okay, so when you get to the end, what you'll do is connect this hair into this braid. So I'm taking piece by piece and just adding it into the braid. Like this piece right here. I'm gonna take a piece of hair. Make sure you have just that one little piece too. And connect it to your hair. And just keep repeating that process. And just finish off by braiding it all the way to the end. And then I'm gonna secure it with a rubber band. So until you can't braid anymore, pretty much is what I'm doing. So about right here, I'm gonna take my rubber band and just tie it off until it's very secure. All right, so like this. So now this is what it looks like. It's really cute, but girl, I know you can see this, not a tit show, but I know you can see that you can see my elastic band and you can see the closure. That's not cute. So this is where your bobby pins come into play, and with the messiness too. So what you want to do is, of course, have your bobby pins on deck. And I'm gonna start with this side. And what I'm gonna do is just take each strand and each loop and stretch them. This is why it's important to braid really tight, because if it's already loose, it's not gonna turn out like this. And it makes like a messy look. And now I'm gonna start on this side and just stretch it on out. And now you don't have to be perfect on this part, but you want to make sure you're stretching it out accordingly so it can cover up that elastic band if you are doing this with a loop. If not, just have it. Okay, so now I'm working on the actual braid. And I'm just doing the same process, the same steps, and just, you know, pulling it all the way through so it's nice and fluffy, nice and big. Then I take my bobby pin and I'm going to go under the loops, under and over kind of. So I definitely want to put one right here, so what I'll do is go in the middle of it and then let the bobby pin go under my elastic band. And now it's just laying flat on my face and you cannot see the elastic band, which you don't need to see anyway, because that is, what is tacky, no. Then I just stretch the rest of the loops accordingly. So I definitely want to put one right here. So I'm gonna do the same. And no, it does not hurt. It's actually pretty pain-free. And plus you get to know that your hair is not gonna slide off at any point of the day. And then for this side, what I'm just mainly trying to cover up is the edges that I may have left out. Just pull that right on back down and slide that bobby pin. Oh, I have one right here, so that bobby pin's still right there. Now I just check to make sure that I have all of the loops down like I like, and that is this finished look. It's super, super simple, super, super easy. I promise you, you can do it. If I can do it, and I don't even know how to braid that well, I know y'all can. Okay, that's all, guys. If you did enjoy this tutorial, please give it a big thumbs up and like, comment, and subscribe to my channel. I will be doing other tutorials as well as makeup tutorials, and just comment down below what other stuff, you know, you'd like to see from me. And if you do recreate it, I would love to see it. Just take a picture. You can either send it to me here on YouTube, send it to my Facebook, my Instagram, Twitter, wherever you'd like, and I will make sure I repost it, because girl, this is a cute hairstyle and it's like perfect for fall. And yeah, I love you all. Thanks for watching. Stay blessed.
Mama told me, not to sell work. Mama 17-5, same color t-shirt, white.
Hey everyone, I'm Bella B, and today I'll be showing, why do I always do that? I hate when I do that. But, my titties out too much.